could go to Disney on Ice if they want to babysit. It's really up to you guys. Just let me know. All right, welcome back, everybody. It's healthy and delicious. Steph said she's in. It's a delicious way to spruce up your lunch or dinner in the new year. So joining us today is Julia Zampano. We love her. She's a dietitian with the Cleveland Clinic Digestive Disease Institute. And she's more here to talk about the Buddha Bowls and the benefits and all that kind of jazz. Happy New Year.
Happy New Year.
Good to see you.
Good to see you, too.
This is fun because I feel like I've seen these, but I didn't know where, like, that it was called a Buddha Bowl. So why is it called a Buddha Bowl?
I'm not sure.
I like it too.
There's so many options with Buddha Bowls too. So I love that you can make them very versatile, healthy. You can have them themed. So you could have an Asian theme, Italian theme, Indian theme bowls, you know, just.
I feel like it won't get old.
No.
So if you take one to work every day.
I mean, they're so great.
Yeah.
They're so great. And you can just switch it up by what veggies you're putting on it, what kind of sauce, what your base is.
Okay.
There's so many ways to switch it up.
Now, I read that usually there's no meat, but you can put meat in it
if
you
typically
want.
Typically they don't have meat. I provided both options.
Yeah.
It's kind of like when you go through some of those newer kind of healthier chain restaurants, and you have all those options, and you can pick and choose what you want in your bowl or salad or whatever it may be. We're recreating that at home with healthier ingredients and healthier toppings and healthier dressings.
And it's easy.
And it's so easy.
I already have my fork ready to go. Okay, so five key ingredients.
Gotcha. Mm-hmm. So five key ingredients. You always want to start off with a base, which is a grain, typically.
Okay.
You want a protein, a vegetable, a fat, and a sauce.
I love me some sauce.
Yes, sauces are great.
They okay, really so what did you bring up. Today? So what is your base?
So my base is these shirataki noodles.
I love those.
Yes. Are good. They're called miracle noodles. They're great. They're very low in carbohydrates. Mm-hmm. So we'll just throw them in our bowl. They're very low in carbohydrates, very, very low, like any at all, depending on the brand you get.
That's better than rice, do you think?
Yeah, I also brought quinoa. So you could
do quinoa.
A little bit of both.
Okay.
Or brown rice. You could do traditional, like a buckwheat noodle. So there's a lot of different things you can do with the base. It's
okay.
Just kind of what flavor you're going with.
Fun.
Yeah, I love the shirataki noodles because I think they go well in this setting.
Yeah.
It's kind of hard to make them in certain, like if you're trying to replace a pasta. But in this type of bowl, they're just mixed in with so much flavor and other vegetables that you don't even notice that they're so kind of little gummier and lighter.
And if you're trying to kind of get rid of pasta in the new year and try new things, this doesn't totally take you off course where you can't keep up with it. You know how you try and do these new things and you're like, you just need to ease into it, baby. Ease into it.
Yeah, ease in.
Right.
Slow and steady.
Slow and steady. All right,
so
what's
then
next?
We have vegetables. So I have some greens here. You can also use greens as a base if you wanted to do like a salad bowl. But this is a mix of cabbage, spinach, some fresh cilantro, and some carrots.
Okay.
And then a whole variety of different veggies.
Oh my goodness.
So you can do some, I just made a kind of an Asian theme. So some broccoli, some mushrooms.
Yes. Is that chicken?
Some snap peas. Yep, chicken.
We should do some chicken.
So you could do chicken. I also have tofu if you want a meatless option.
I don't know if I've ever had tofu.
Tofu's great.
Should I give it a try?
Yes, absolutely.
Can you do both?
Yeah, you can do both.
I mean, how much is too much in your bowl? We're trying to cut back on those portion controls.
Yes.
Right?
So really, that's why I really focused on a ton of vegetables.
Okay.
So you want to fill, there's almost no such thing as too many vegetables, right?
True.
So you can really, really fill it up with veggies. You want an appropriate amount of protein, like 3 to 4 ounces is just fine.
Okay.
But you know, you want to pick vegetables too that have extra protein. Like I have some beans, some legumes here. I always recommend putting beans in there. These are some edamame beans. Mm-hmm. I think they go great with it. I like to add some onions because they'll add extra flavor.
Yeah, those are good too.
And these are pickled onions, but you could do sauteed onions. I have some finely chopped radishes here too because they'll add some nice crunch to it and a little bit more color, which we love, especially if you have kids, you want to have a lot of different color.
Yes.
And a nice little bowl or
it might make them more apt to.
Exactly. And when they make it, it really helps
because
they're picking what they want in it.
Right,
you know?
Right. Okay, so we got about 30 seconds.
I'm gonna put some tofu in here.
Now for the dressing, does it matter?
It does matter. So I
tend to do like an Asian dressing. It's
okay.
Sesame ginger dressing. If you're like in a pinch and you don't have time to make dressing and you don't want a store-bought one,
yeah.
I'll use olive oil, vinegar, salt, and pepper.
Oh, that's so good.
This is extra virgin olive oil. These are liquid aminos.
Okay.
They're a soy sauce alternative, which is much lower in sodium, and it's wheat-free. So I'll use that with maybe a little toasted sesame oil. I like to use some sesame seeds. Those are great. They'll add flavor, so we have our fat from the oil and maybe from the nuts.
Okay.
So these are some slivered almonds, I think, are great. Again, crunch, and some sunflower seeds. Yeah. So like this is
the dressing?
Yep, that's the dressing.
Can I pour it?
Yes, please do.
Oh my goodness. Look at that.
So good. So good.
Did you make your own dressing?
I did. I made
You made your own dressing?
I did.
I'll tell you if it's good or not.
It is good. This is another one that I made. This is a tahini. It's nice to have like a creamy tahini dressing.
I love creamy.
Yes.
Oh my gosh, so good. Okay, all the details are on our website, fox8.com. You can get the health tips there as well. Always so good to see you.
So good to see you.
This is a good idea. This is a great transition.
Perfect.
More vegetables.
Yes.
We'll be
Go vegetables.
More vegetables.